They have hidden in our midst for centuries. A strange race of genetically enhanced beings known as the Inhumans.
What's going on, everybody? This is going to be my non-spoilery Inhumans review. I'll try to explain what's going on with the series. You've probably heard a whole bunch of stuff. I've seen the first two episodes, so that's what this will cover. And because there's still a whole bunch of Marvel TV stuff that's going to start this year and next year, like there's a Deadpool TV show that's going to be happening that I'll explain, I'll just do a new round of the Netflix giveaway. All you have to do to enter is be a subscriber and leave a Marvel-related comment on this video. You know, whether you loved Inhumans or you hated it, doesn't matter, it's totally cool. This will try to cover some of the issues that I had with the first couple of episodes, the things that I thought that they did well, and what the rest of the season is going to look like. There are 8 episodes total, if you didn't know. It's more of a mini-series than an actual TV show. So you've probably been hearing or seeing, like on Rotten Tomatoes with their 0% rating, that most people have been trashing the series. And I'll say at least most of the criticisms that you've heard of it are totally valid. And it's all a function, I think, of a couple things. There's really like 2 big problems with this. And I think a lot of it goes back to how it got started. Like the reason why Jeff Loeb, president of Marvel TV, and the other powers that be said, green light, let's go, Inhumans TV show. So all the trailers that you've been seeing for this, like the first trailer that everybody was making fun of, the subsequent trailers, that is all footage right out of the first couple of episodes. It looks exactly like that. So I went to see it in IMAX theaters. Like I paid the full ticket price. It was like $20 plus for the first 2 episodes. It ended up being about 120 minutes. So it was really like 2 episodes taken from television, just jammed together and aired back to back. But aside from Black Bolt's performance, I think a lot of the cast suffered from really, really bad scripts. And I think actors like Maximus, I'm probably going to mispronounce his name, Iwan Rheon, I always mess it up a little bit. He is a great actor. Serinda Swan is in Ballers on HBO right now. She's had some good scenes during that with The Rock. They're capable of good performances. So when you hear people making fun of their costumes, like making fun of her wig, that was a big thing when the first trailer dropped. What the hell is going on with this? I think most of the problems that the series has had so far is just in those things. It's not the actors specifically. They're capable of delivering good performances. But here, this will blow your mind a little bit. So originally, the whole reason that this became a TV show is because Isaac Perlmutter, the person who used to be Kevin Feige's boss, is the CEO of Marvel, said, we want an Inhumans movie. He forced Kevin Feige to put it on their schedule, like at the tail end. So it's like, okay, we'll deal with that when we get to it. Kevin Feige, never really interested in doing an Inhumans movie. One, mostly because they're just not that popular of a group. Like even my buddies, Comicstorian and Comics Explained, have had trouble with their Inhumans videos. They just haven't been super popular compared to other comic book characters. So one, Kevin Feige, as a business decision, is like, you know, Inhumans, probably not the strongest thing for us to go with. And it kind of hurts our relationship with Fox because on paper, on screen, they read a lot like X-Men. So it could cause all kinds of diplomatic problems if they ever wanted to use X-Men characters in the Marvel movies. So it was a bit of a mess behind the scenes originally. But then you all heard about how Marvel Studios, the film part of their business, got separated so Kevin Feige doesn't have to report to anybody but the head of Disney anymore. They can do whatever they want. In Marvel Television, the people that make all the TV shows are a completely separate division that have almost no relation and no contact with the movie people anymore. So after that happened, Inhumans was taken off of the movie schedule, so it was free for the TV people to do if they ever wanted to. Then that was the last you heard of it. But earlier this year, what happened is because the last couple of weeks you may have heard stories about how movie box office is way down. Like almost nobody is going to see movies the last couple of weeks, so theater exhibitors are really worried about that. In IMAX, didn't have any big IMAX releases that were happening around this time. So what happened is IMAX went to Marvel TV and says, do you have something that you can premiere in IMAX theaters for a brief period just to sort of bridge the gap till we get to all the big movies that are coming later this fall? Like you have Thor Ragnarok, you have Star Wars Episode 8. Those will all be big IMAX releases. So, you know, people earn plenty of money later this year. They just needed something to tide them over. So Marvel's like, you know what? We could do Inhumans as a big IMAX release, and then we'll debut it as a miniseries. So originally, the idea for the Inhumans TV show started with this IMAX partnership. They funded part of those first couple of episodes. They gave them extra money to do extra special effects, big action scenes. If you're going to charge someone $20 a ticket for an IMAX experience, I mean, you better deliver something really badass. But then after that, they're like, okay, why don't we just cap the series off with 6 more episodes? It'll be a mini series, and that'll be the end of it. If it's successful, we'll keep doing it. So it's not a bad idea. Like, oh, okay, that's great. You know, we'll do a big TV series. We'll debut it in IMAX. But here's where the real problem starts, is that Marvel TV only had 6 weeks to get that pilot going, meaning they had to write the story, they had to cast all the actors, make all the costumes, find all the sets, put all that stuff together that you see in the trailers in under 6 weeks. So what does that sound like? It also sounds a little bit like what happened with Iron Fist this season, when Finn Jones showed up during Defenders and he actually looked pretty decent in his fight scenes. People were like, oh, he can actually do this. He's not as terrible as he seemed during Iron Fist. And even if you loved Iron Fist, there were so many production issues with that. He said that sometimes they would show up on set and rehearse fights day of, and the fight scenes are one of the biggest selling points of Iron Fist. His kung fu is such a big part of his character, you'd think that they would spend longer developing those. So you have to imagine that when you're watching the first couple of Inhumans episodes, you're watching something that was cobbled together on the fly. So it's like, oh, okay, I understand why these fight scenes don't look particularly spectacular, why the dialogue isn't that great, and why the scripts seem really weak. So again, I'll say all the criticisms that you've heard are 100% valid. I mean, some people are going a little overboard with the criticism. It looks exactly like what ABC and Marvel TV could put together if you gave them 6 weeks. And usually really good TV shows are in development for years before they actually shoot the pilot. So also, as part of that budgetary constraints, the way they cobbled stuff together, that's part of the reason why I think they chose to shoot it on Earth. Because part of the big comic book appeal of the Inhumans is that they're super weird. They represent some of the best Jack Kirby, Stan Lee weirdness in the Marvel Universe. They're largely space-based, so I think the reason to not do it in outer space is mostly a cost decision. They're like, okay, we're gonna air this on ABC, we can't make it too weird because that's network TV, we don't have a lot of money to build all these big sets in outer space, so we'll set it on Earth. That'll explain why they always look like they're walking around downtown Hawaii. And at the end of the day, they just bake a lot of the cool stuff out of the series. So I do think it's possible for them to make a good Inhumans TV show, and we haven't seen anything beyond the 2nd episode. So presumably they saw a lot of the early backlash, and hopefully they were able to respond to that in time. But they've already finished shooting the series, and I'm not super hopeful, just based on the first couple of episodes, that this will get a season 2. They might just bill it as a miniseries and just close up shop and say, maybe we'll revisit this way down the road. Or if we ever want to debut the characters in the movies, they could always do that too. But I think that most people will go into this, see Black Bolt and the other characters and be like, wait a minute, Black Bolt is part of the Illuminati, he's on the level of Iron Man, the other most powerful characters in the Marvel Cinematic Universe, and this is what he looks like. This is not what I expected, and then they'll all just start shaking their fists. So just expect to hear a lot of people going crazy about why they don't like Inhumans. But again, just remember what happened with Iron Fist. Like, people went crazy when that came out. Like, this is not what I expected at all. Netflix is a little bit different from the ABC shows. They can go darker, they almost have unlimited money, and they don't have to worry about pissing off advertisers, so they can do pretty much whatever they want. So it's a lot easier for them to pivot on criticism and fix things behind the scenes that need to be fixed than it is for big network TV shows. So what'll happen is Inhumans is debuting right at the end of the month. They're going to air all 8 episodes on ABC, and then right after that, around Thanksgiving, Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. is going to premiere and just air its entire season without any breaks. So that'll all be Friday nights now. Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. and Inhumans are both Friday night TV shows. And I will say, once you watch Inhumans, you will actually appreciate more what Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. was able to do with those characters, even though they weren't allowed to do the royal family. But what I think will happen is if they don't do Inhumans Season 2, is that they'll just cameo the characters on Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. without doing a corresponding Inhumans episode. But let me know in the comments, what did you guys think of Inhumans, and do you actually think that they'll try to fix things and do a season 2, or do you think they'll just wrap up shop and put it on a shelf and forget that it ever happened? So if you're feeling really bummed out about all this, don't worry. Punisher is coming in November, around the time that Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. is coming. I think Punisher drops before Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. drops, and Punisher is going to wreck everything. It's going to be awesome. So I'll say congratulations to the latest giveaway winner, Isaac Kramer. Please private message me on the back end of my channel so I can get your contact details. While you wait for everything, click here for brand new Punisher footage, and you can click here for the blooper reel from The Flash. Thank you so much for watching. Everybody stay awesome. I'll see you guys tonight.